तिमरन दस्य ज्ञानंजन शलाकया चक्षुरुमिलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय सदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः। संख्या पूर्वक नाम गान नाथ भी कालावसानि कृतौ निद्राहार विहार कादि विचतौ चत्यंत दीन छयो गोपी भावर सामृतावलहरि कल्लोलमग्नौ वंदे रूप सनातनौ भटजगौ श्रीजीव गोपालकौ। नमो भक्ति विनोदाय सच्चिदानंद नामने गौर शक्ति स्वरूपाय रूपानुगावराय ते। श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि गौर भक्तवृंदा हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे। वी आर सो मच ग्रेटफुल एंड थैंकफुल टू दिस ग्रेट पर्सनालिटी श्री श्रील भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर इटर्नली इंडेटेड टू श्रील भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर फॉर हिज कंपैशन एंड फॉर हिज ब्लेसिंग्स टू दिस वर्ल्ड। इंट्रोड्यूसिंग श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु His teachings to all of us, otherwise we would have been bereft of understanding the Gaudiya philosophy. We have no words to thank Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur for this. Saying thank you is minimizing the glories of this personality. That word has not so much gravity of what he have done for us and entire world. If we go deep, what to speak of the books, just the songs of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur. The songs of Bhaktivinoda Thakur melts the heart. And giving so much encouragement and inspiration, no words to glorify this personality. Therefore, in this Pranam mantra, we see Gaur Karuna Shakti. It's Karuna, embodiment of the Karuna, compassion of Mahaprabhu, potency Shri Gadadhar Pandit. I get surprised and amazed to read Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur's books, which is the essence of the books of Sri Goswamis. If you have this vision, if you have this understanding, this concept, I guarantee you, if we seriously read the books of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, everything is present in that. The books of Rupa Goswami, the books of Jiva Goswami, Sri Raghunath Das Goswami, everything just in the books of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur and his songs. And being after that, keeping himself in so humble position. So humble, not taking any credit. Shri Bhajan Dasya. performing kirtan of the eighth pair of names, Hare Hare. The sadhaka engages in the sweet prem seva of Radha Krishna in the manifested Braj Dham throughout the eight divisions of the day and night, Ashtakal, eightfold pastimes of Radha and Krishna, Ashtakal. That means, this is the indication, the eighth pair of names, Hare Hare, is the stage of perfection. Why? Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying, the sadhaka engages in the sweet prem seva of Radha Krishna in the manifested Brajadham. Manifested Brajadham. Who can get entrance into that manifested pastime in that Brajadham? When one gets Siddhi, perfection. Sarup Siddhi and then Vastu Siddhi. Sarup Siddhi means a perfection stage where one only come to know about one's eternal form. But there is something more than that. What is that? Ekadash Bhav. What we heard yesterday. These 11 indications. Name, form, complexion, instruction, seva, which group. Yeah. That is revealed when one gets Vastu Siddhi. This is also one of the reasons of Krishna to come descend from Golok Vrindavan to this material world, to provide access to those who already got perfection, Sarup Siddhi, but they need to function, they need to grow, they need to advance more. Just by knowing one's eternal form is not enough. One needs functioning. One needs to serve. Because after crossing all these stages, so many births take place. Srila Gurudev said, he used to say many times, after 50 births, if you all come to the stage of even Ruchi, after 50 births, if you come to the stage of Ruchi, then consider it happens very quick because of the mercy of Guru and Vaishnavas. 50 births, not years. Understand? So it's not about one birth. And who knows how many births we are practicing and we are coming to this stage of understanding. And many more to come. Many more to come. But by taking shelter of Mahajan. Mahajan means Nityanand Prabhu. Srila Bhakti Thakur says, Nadiya Godrume Nityanand Mahajan. Pati ache naam hata jivir akara shaddhavan janahe shaddhavan jan pati ache naam hata jivir akara Nityanand Mahajan. Nityanand Prabhu is Mahapurusha. Vande Mahapurushate Charanarvindam. But Srila Bhakti Thakur is also Mahajan. Mahajana je gata sapantaha, following the footsteps of Mahajans. Understand? Therefore, That's one reason Krishna has to come and give access and that platform where all those, try to understand this formula, all those who attain perfection, means till the stage of bhav, not only from this universe, from infinite universes. Because every universe, someone or the other also doing bhajan and crossing these stages. We are not always taking birth and death only in this universe. No. We take birth in another universe, then from another universe. So much traveling is going on. So all those who get sarup siddhi, the perfection of getting their eternal sarup, their form, from all the universe, they come and join together in that particular universe where Krishna performing his manifest pastimes. When he comes with all his associates to facilitate those who are on this stage and to give them some functioning now. Isn't it the mercy and compassion of Krishna? He has to leave his eternal abode and come here. For many reasons, I'm not saying only one reason, but this is also one of the reasons. Are you understanding my point? To help all those sadhakas who attain the stage of bhav, and now they have to come to the stage of prema because they have to go back. They have to go to Golok Vrindavan to serve divine couples, but they need some practical training. Practical training. Learn, as we say in this world, learn while you work. You have to be under one trainer at the work situation and you learn there. So the teachers who's teaching us there is Lalita and Vishakha, direct. Rupa Manjari, Rati Manjari, direct. And Kamala Manjari is also there. Srila Bhakti Thakur is also there. So under their guidance and instruction, one get this stage of prema and functioning, serving divine couple, Radha Krishna. Understand? So someone from here got perfection, goes there. Someone from other universe, someone from other universe. That's the reason why Krishna comes. To help with vastu siddhi, the functioning, the seva of the sadhaka. So, this is the meditation of the eighth pair of Naam. That means this is a stage of prem. A sadhak reached that stage of prem. In other words, the sadhak attains service imbued with the mood of the gopis in his eternal form, eternal sarupa. That's the meaning of Hare Hare, the eighth pair. That's the perfection. As he performs Naam Bhajan of this pair of names, he remembers the pastimes of Sri Radha Krishna's meeting, in which the completely dedicated manjaris of Sri Radha are serving Sri Yugal. Sorry, someone was asking a question. So, as he performed Naam Bhajan, of this pair of names, he remembers the pastimes of Sri Radha Krishna meeting. Now, this is the stage of meditating on the pastimes of Radha Krishna meeting. If anyone do before that stage, what one will conclude? Oh, just like Radharani is an ordinary girl, Krishna is a boy, and they're meeting together, and all those love affairs. Because our consciousness is only restricted to this point. We are not even beyond that. We have not crossed that stage. So this is what we conclude. That's why it is not advisable to do this in this stage. But more and more when we advance in bhakti, especially after anartha nivritti, then the concept is very much clear and pure. And on the stage of Hare Hare, the conception is completely pure. How it will happen? Not only by chanting, but also some service to Guru and Vaishnavas while chanting. To make chanting pure. To make chanting that pure. So much has been done only because of this reason. Somebody asked the question, why we have to chant mantras? If Maha Mantra is everything. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is not explaining about mantras. He's only explaining about Maha Mantra. And what is the role of the mantras, what we chant? Mantra means mantraiditi mantra. One who help control our mind is called mantras. Srila Bhakti Raksha Sridhar Gosai Maharaj explains, mantras, with the potency of mantra, one gets situated in Vaikunth Dham. But our aim is Golok Vrindavan, which is even far away Vaikuntha. Or we can say the something which cross Vaikuntha and which is something higher than Vaikuntha. So the Mahamantra leads us to Golok Vrindavan. And mantra helps us to reach Vaikuntha. So ultimate is Mahamantra. But we get more preference when our Gurudev give us Harinam. We think, oh, this is ordinary, simple Harinam. But when we receive mantras from Gurudev, then we understand, oh, because this mantra has to be chanted without speaking, only in the mind, even without moving the lips. So these are more important. And Maha Mantra is loudly and singing and dancing. That's less important. No. Maha Mantra is the direct surup of the form of Radha and Krishna, direct. And in Maha Mantra, all the pastimes of Radha Krishna are present, as you devotees have learned the meaning of Maha Mantra. Hare and Krishna, then Hare and Krishna. The meaning. And in that meaning explained by Jiva Goswami, what we see, I mean, what we understand by that, we understand that from the perspective of Jiva Goswami, that pastimes of Radha Krishna are present in those each and every syllable in Maha Mantra. So Maha Mantra is seed and Maha Mantra is the fruit. Maha Mantra is sadhan, practice. Maha Mantra is sadhe, the perfection. Whereas mantras, they help and assist us to the stage of coming, bringing us to the stage of purely chanting Harinam. So when we receive mantras, what we are getting? Samskar. Once samskar is done. Samskar means purification. When anyone buy a new house, A yajna is performed there. Why? House is clean, new paint, everything good. Why yajna? To purify the house, to do samskar of the house. Similarly, this body going through so many ups and downs from so many lifetimes, he need to get some samskara done. And that samskara means initiation, receiving the mantras. But ultimately, Harinam is everything. Harinam is everything. So, Shri Bhajan Raise is truly... No, I skipped one line. In which completely dedicated manjaris of Shri Radha are serving Shri Yugal by offering betel, massaging their feet, and so on. That's the perfection. That's Hare Hare. And this is what is called Ekadash Bhav, we heard yesterday. And this is what is called Vastu Siddhi, means functioning of that eternal form. In that universe where Krishna brought all his associates there. And that's why Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is writing in his song. I'm telling you, each and every line of the songs of Bhaktivinoda Thakur is the whole Gaudiya philosophy. Remember, many times I sing this. Many devotees might be thinking, oh Maharaj, every time singing this. In this song, Gopinath Mama Nivedan Suno. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur is writing, Jivara karane asiya prapanche lila kaile suvistar lila kaile suvistar. What is the meaning? Jivara karane asiya prapanche. For the jivas, Shri Krishna, who is not the resident of material world, who is the resident of spiritual world, but he descend in this material world for the benefit of the jivas. And what is the benefit of the jivas? This is what we are explaining. To help the jivas getting functioning with their eternal form. Jivare karane asya prapanche. He expands his pastimes. He brings his associates with him. Looks like, not looks like, but this is true, Krishna's enjoyer. But from the ordinary perspective, ordinary people perspective, oh, he's enjoyer. He just come here and have some enjoyment and then he goes. That's not the true concept. The true concept is he, although he comes here and he enjoys here with his associates, with his sakhis, with Radharani, but as I said, the service mood is imbibed. The service of Krishna to help jivas who already reached perfection but now they need some functioning to go back, to go to Shri Golok Vrindavan Dham. So no one can go directly to Golok Vrindavan Dham. It has to be through this procedure, this route. It has to be this route. First getting birth in that universe where Krishna descends with his associates, getting function there, functioning there, getting some service there, and by getting practical training from Lalita and Vishakha and other manjaris and gopis, then going to Shri Golok Vrindavan Dham, eternally situated there. So, Srila Gurudev is saying, Shri Bhajan Raise is truly a Shri Bhajan Raise is truly a treasure chest of rahasyas. Rahasyas means secrets. A chest of secrets. And I'm very much convinced, really it is a chest of secrets. What secrets? Bhajan secrets. Intimate secrets. The secret of the qualification to enter bhajan इज हिडन इन द फर्स्ट याम ऑफ भजन रहस्य, निशांत भजन. रिमेंबर वी हर्ड दिस इज निशांत लीला, फर्स्ट याम, 3:30 AM to 6 AM. वी आर स्टिल ऑन दैट पॉइंट. दिस निशांत भजन, द सीक्रेट ऑफ क्वालिफिकेशन टू एंटर दैट भजन इज हिडन इन द फर्स्ट याम ऑफ भजन रहस्य, निशांत भजन. द सीक्रेट इज कॉल्ड श्रद्धा. श्रद्धा मीन्स फेथ. श्रद्धा मीन्स फेथ. एंड वट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ श्रद्धा? ओके, हु विल टेल? इज त्रिदेश्वरी देयर? त्रिदेश्वरी, वट इज द डेफिनेशन ऑफ श्रद्धा? No, I think she's not there. Achha. I want to hear from someone. Let me check. Anant Krishna? No? Okay. Sudevi? You know the definition of Shraddha? No. Okay. If you don't know, Braj Kishore? No. My God. My students are sometimes too much. Chandrika? Dasi? No. Jayashree? Yes. Huh? Okay, finally coming to Tarani Gopi and Radha Sundari. They know. I'm fully confident. Yes? Yes. Unmute them. See? They have answer to every question.
Namaste Namaraj. The definition of Shraddha is Shraddha Shabde Vishwasaka Hai Sudhrida Nishchay.
Why you both speak together? Huh? Okay, what is the meaning?
The word of the definition Shraddha is the having the faith that by performing Krishna Bhakti, all other activities are automatically performed.
Exactly. Thank you. The firm faith, not the faith. The firm determination that by performing Krishna Bhakti, everything else is already performed, accomplished, or everything is inclusive in that. That's Shraddha. So this first yam of Bhajan Rese, the secret is Shraddha, the faith. In other words, this is leading us to the firm faith. Vishwas karo, firm faith. Bhakti Thakur is giving his sanction or his promise. Believe me. Shall we believe him or not? He's speaking with his realization. That's why his words have so much gravity and importance. Not just saying, he is, you know, realizing this. So that's the secret of first yam, Nishant Bhajan. And that is Shraddha, the faith. After the stage of Sadhu Sangha, when sadhan is executed through the performance of Nam Sankirtan under the shelter of the spiritual master and with Sambandh Gyan, anarthas are eliminated. Eliminated. So, what comes after Sadhu Sangha? Bhajan Kriya. Performance of Bhajan, but not independent Bhajan, in the guidance of spiritual master. That's a very important point. It gives so much pain to the heart. When we see someone is not even connected to Gurudev. And what happens? We have seen so many examples. Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, after he left this world, because there was no connection with any Shiksha Guru, many and many and many devotees got so much weak. Similarly with Srila Gurudev, after he left this world, no connection, thinking, oh, I know everything. Or even if this point that I know everything, or even in this point that I will choose. I have to choose. Then if the point comes, you have to choose, means you will choose according to your comfort zone. I'm very comfortable with this person. Why are you not comfortable with one who is training you? No, because he finds fault in me. He's correcting me. He's chastising me. Never saying you are good. So that's not a comfort zone. So everywhere, every step, we always have sense enjoyment. Even to this point. Even to this point. On Guru Purnima Day, we used to be with Srila Gurudev in Mathura. You can't imagine how many people, like hundreds and hundreds of people standing in a queue to have just 1 minute speaking with Gurudev. With garlands, with donations, with sweets, cloths, etc. on Guru Purnima. Because they have this concept, we have to worship our Gurudev at least once a year, and that is on Guru Purnima. Yeah. So they are standing in line for hours and hours waiting this time, because big line all the way till the road, from the mud stairs and then all the road people are standing, and we are surprised how many, that many people. I mean, we are staying in the mud in the center, we never see so many people coming. And then Gurudev used to make fun of them when they are coming. Guruji, this flowers for you, Guruji. And sometimes I used to stand next to Gurudev to receive, you know, the fruits, whatever people offering to Gurudev, and he used to hold and keep in the container. And I hear every time Guruji telling to everyone, oh, meri yaad aa gayi. That means, oh, you remember me now. Once a year, remembering Gurudev once a year. And in the evening time, Gurudev used to speak Hari Katha, and he's expressing his concern. Don't become disciples, Srila Gurudev said. Don't become that kind of disciples as you have seen whole day today, Gurudev is telling to us, brahmacharis, sannyasis, and those who are serious ones staying for his Hari Katha. Don't become like them. They only take this as a ritual to worship Guru on Guru Purnima Day, because it's a special day and only meant to worship Gurudev. So they said, don't become like them. They're taking Gurudev not so seriously. They're taking Guru Tattva very easy for just taking as a traditional. That's all. So we can imagine how sad Gurudev is, that I've given them my love, my affection. I want to give them more. I want to train them more. And Gurudev used to say, you cannot repay me in any lifetime of what I have given to you. You cannot repay me. So Gurudev is not meant to be worshipped once a year. Srila Bhakti Thakur is not meant to worship only twice a year on his appearance and disappearance day. Reading Srila Bhakti Thakur books chanting is singing his bhajans is actually serving him and remembering him every day. Every day. So, after the stage of sadhu sangha, in the stage of sadhu sangha, the bhajan performed under the guidance of Srila Gurudev, spiritual master, with sambandh gyan, with relationship, not without relationship. How many times did you, Gurudev used to ask, how many times you remember me? And devotees go to shame. How can you develop sambandha, the relationship, if you're not in contact? And that was a time when there was not so much facilities. And nowadays, we have so much social media to contact. There's WhatsApp, there's Messenger, there's so many. It's so easy. But we have to understand that gravity. Gravity. Gurudev, I love you, but once a year. So, when there is no sambandha gyan with Gurudev, how we can think of sambandha with bhakti and sambandha with relationship with Krishna? Isn't it neglecting? That's called neglecting Gurudev. The first verse of Sri Shikshtashtak, Cheto Darpan Marjanam, indicates the most favorable process of bhajan for this stage. Indicates the most favorable process of bhajan for this stage. The second yam, Prata Kaliya Bhajan. Now, just in this chapter, Srila Gurudev is describing in brief what is present and what details are present in particular yam. So what we heard up till now was the pratham yam, the first yam. Second yam, Prataha Kaliya Bhajan. First yam was Nishant Bhajan. Understand? Nisha means darkness and ant means the end of darkness. Now this is the term for this second yam. We start from 6 o'clock. It's called Prata Kaliya Bhajan. See, this is so important to know. In these 3 hours, if we just remember 1 minute, what Krishna is doing in this time, that's enough for our meditation every day. It's just a practice. So, Prata Kaliya Bhajan. Prata means early morning. Prata Kaliya Bhajan holds the secret of the removal of anarthas, anarth nivritti, in the association of devotees. That means sunrise. When sunrise, what happens? Darkness immediately goes away. Thieves, dacoits, snakes, ghosts, subtle bodies, they just run away because of the presence of sun. Shri Shukdev Goswami in Bhagavatam, right in the beginning of the chapter, Ajamil, he's proving this. Kechit kevalya bhaktaya vasudev parayanam agan dhuvanti karse nihar evari bhaskara. Just like sun rise, kechit kevalya bhaktaya vasudev parayanam. When sun rise, all negativities, all evil, everything goes far away. Similarly, kechit kevalya bhaktiya, the kevala bhakti means, see, there are many names of shuddha bhakti, pure bhakti. Remember this. Because in Bhagavatam, other scriptures will come across these names. But it means the same. Pure bhakti means shuddha bhakti, kevala bhakti, amala bhakti. These are the same. So, kechit kevalya bhaktaya. Just like in the Guru Puja, the very first line. Shri Guru Charana Padma Kevala Bhakati Sadma Vandamoi Savadhana Mate. There are two meanings of this. Shri Guru Charana Padma, the lotus feet of Srila Gurudev, Kevala Bhakati Sadma. Keval means only. That's a Hindi word, Sanskrit word. Keval means only, means the lotus feet of Sri Gurudev is the only means to attain pure bhakti. But there's another meaning. The lotus feet of Srila Gurudev is the only way, means by serving the lotus feet, is the only way to attain kevala bhakati sadma, kevala bhakti. Kevala bhakti means pure bhakti, shuddha bhakti. Okay, so in this early morning bhajan, prata kalya bhajan, holds the secret of the removal of anarthas, means anartha nivritti. Understand? Comparison with the sun, when this bhajan becomes prominent, then anarthas, which are negativities, they goes away in the association of devotees. Nam means the holy name, and Nami, the possessor of the name, are non-different in tattva. What is the verse? Jayashree. Nam and Nami, non-different in tattva. They are same. Only Jayashree will tell this. Yes or no? No. Achha. Ananta knows this? Ananta, you need to learn verses. Because this is the only age to learn. Later, when you become old like me, all this gray, this hair, all this like me, that's the time of forgetting the verses. Your age is the time to learn verses. Achha, no worries. It's okay. Achha. And Dhanishta, you know what I'm speaking about? No idea. Achha. Nam and Nami are non-different. Priyadasi, where is Kanadas? He knows this. Achha. No. Some devotees were on screen. When I ask question, they just switch off their screen. I will do same. Achha. Kaun bolega? Isha Mata knows? Your son, he needs to learn those verses. Yes. Achha. Coming back to Radha Sundari and Taravani Gopi. What is that verse?
Then with Prinam Maharaj, the first was, I think, Nama Chintamani Krishna Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha Nitya
Purna Shuddho
Nitya Mukto Bhinatva Nama Namino.
Very good. Nama Chintamani Krishna Chaitanya Rasa Vigraha Purna Shuddho Nitya Mukto अभिनत्व नाम नामनी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड्स दिस प्रूव्स देयर इज नो आई मीन दिस वर्ड सेज दैट देयर इज नो डिफरेंस बिटवीन द नाम एंड द नामी द पोजेसर ऑफ द नेम एंड द नेम सो दे आर नॉन डिफरेंट इन तत्व mercy not French mercy this mercy and all other potencies of the personification of Nam are placed within the name of Bhagwan okay mercy and all other potencies why it's not written like this that all other potencies why it is said mercy and all other potencies because mercy is what is the word for mercy karuna the mercy potency of the lord as I explained many times is the middle part of the lotus which holds the all other petals you know the middle part the wall holds the all other petals similarly all other potencies are surrounded or get hold by the mercy potency so mercy potency is the what do you say prominent amongst all other potencies so mercy and all other potencies of the personification of Nam are placed within the name of Bhagwan and cleansing the heart cheto darpan marjanam becomes possible by performing such bhajan so many details here the second yam explains the secret of nam bhajan in accordance with the mood of the second verse of shikshashtak which begins with the word nam nam akari okay so eight pairs hare krishna eight pairs And how many yams are there? Eight yams. And how many verses in Shikshashtakam? Eight verses. So this is the connection Srila Bhakti Thakur is saying. In other words, what Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is saying, he recite these eight verses, is in connection with the eight yams. Is in connection with the eight pairs of Mahamantra. That's the secret of Bhajan Rasa. Srila Bhakti Thakur is trying to connect these three together. Understand? He's trying to connect these three together. So, Pratham Yam, 3:30-6, Cheto Darpan Marjanam. Second Yam, the second verse, Nam Nam Akari Bahuda. निज सर्व शक्ति तत्रार्पिता नियमते स्मरण कालः एतादृशी तव कृपया भगवान ममापि दुर्देवम इदृशी इह जानी नानुरागा ओके भजन विद फर्म फेथ मींस निष्ठा फर्म फेथ इज निष्ठा is the subject of the third yam. What is the name of this yam? The third one? Purvan Kaliya Bhajan. You have to remember this. See, this is our study session. So if I'm speaking this topic in Vrindavan or in Kartik Parikrama, then we don't have to just go in details. Because many of you are learning this, let's have to stop and explain that. First is Nishant Leela. Second is Prata Kalya Leela. Third is Purvan Leela. Purvan Leela. Okay. Bhajan with firm faith is called Bhajan Nishta, is the subject of the third yam, Purvan Kalya Bhajan. Performing Nam Bhajan with Nishta means firm faith extinguishes the blazing forest fire of material existence. Bhav Mahadavagni Nirvapanam. Bhajan that is performed without pride and with respect for others in relation to their respective positions is a secret hidden within this yam. That's the secret of this particular section. Giving respect to others in proportion to their adhikar, to their qualification. Not like, oh, my devotee, my friend is devotee and I have my Gurudev, so I'm giving equal respect because Gurudev is also a devotee and my friend is also a devotee. No. Not equal. In proportion. With regard to their qualification. Huh. So bhajan that is performed without pride. If bhajan is performed with pride, then this is third canto Bhagavatam, the instruction Kapil Bhagwan giving to Mother Devoti. That bhakti is performed in the mode of ignorance, bhakti is performed in the mode of passion, and the bhakti is performed in the mode of goodness. When bhakti is performed in the mode of passion, then this Avisandhaya Yodamba Masarjam Helam Evava. Bhakti performed in the mode of passion, not even goodness. Okay. But here, the secret in this yam, Bhaktivinoda Thakur is saying, when bhakti performed without pride, not to achieve pride, but without pride, and with respect for others in relation to their respective positions, is the secret hidden within this yam. That is stated in the words of the third verse of Shikshashtak. You see, this third yam is the third verse. And what is that? Pirnadapi suni jena tarorapi seheshuna amanina manadena kirtane sadahari. Third yam connected to the third verse of Shikshashtak. Okay. Gaur Premanande Hari Hari Bolo Vrindavan Bihari Lal Ki Jai Jai Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur Ki Jai. Shri, all glories to Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, all glories to Bhaktivinoda Thakur, all glories to Bhaktivinoda Thakur, and all and all and all glories to Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur.